Welcome to everybody to my YouTube channel. I am your host, Full Circle 420. Here I'm doing a reaction video to this episode of My Sexual Power Life through Paul's Journey. It was season 10, episode 6. And I'm going to be talking through it due to, you know, how YouTube is. And, you know, I ain't going to be here with no copyright strike or anything like that. So I will be muting this for copyright purposes. Because, well, the music, that is, not the, you know, the music, not the...
I'm miserable.
The music, not the video. At least I'm going to try to mute it, though. If not, well, I mean, it's just instrumental, so we don't know who the artist is. Oh, well. So, let's get started, okay? And this, I guess this right dude right here is Paul or whoever he is. I think it's just some kind of advertisement, but let's watch and see.
And food is the only thing that helps me with the pain.
Oh, we don't want to see it jump in and out due to copyrights. And then I guess the person who owns the channel did not want to get a copyright strike. So it's going to be moving up and down. Going to be, you know, large, small, large, small, large, small, or anything like that. Just saying.
Somewhere in me is this little glimmer of hope. I just want to be a normal person.
You can't do it, and then I just get mad.
If I don't make a change now, I'm scared it's going to be too late.
And I noticed something. It's an ongoing pattern with these so-called participants of the show. I know something. It's always something. It's always some mental trauma they went through as a child, or some mental trauma they went through as a child, a teenager. Well, still children to me. So, it's always some mental illness. It's always some mental abuse or some physical abuse that, you know, attached to their mental illness. There's always some reason why they're this size. It never fails. Or for some females and some males, they were like sexually abused or something like that, or their father was never in their life, or their mother abused them, or their mother neglected them, or anything like that. It's always something. They use food as a comfort. Do the research.
For as long as I can handle. It just got to be too much for me.
A Timothy's nugget and a large chocolate shake?
I noticed something. Nobody ever on here gaining 600 pounds by eating fruits and vegetables. Just saying. Oh, my. Busy, you know what I'm saying? Watching my 600 pound life. Or in this case, my 750 pound life.
I never thought my life would be like this.
Nobody ever does.
Never thought I'd be 750 pounds. And at my size, I'm miserable. My back aches, my knees, my toes.
You know, this could also, see, people like to talk about drugs, like marijuana. Well, drugs, marijuana's not a drug, but like cocaine, this and that, and the other. Little do people realize, food is like one of the most biggest, most dangerous drugs, especially if you overcompensate some trauma that you've been through. I'm telling you, dude, food can be a drug too. Food is definitely a drug. Anything that causes a chemical change to the body is a drug. Food is definitely a drug. Water is a drug. Everything we use is drugs. So let's not distinguish between one and the other.
I mean, everything about my body hurts. The only thing that helps me with the pain is food. And the thought of being able to eat is what motivates me to get up and get out of bed. Because because I have to take a shower. And that's a painful ordeal for me. And I hate it.
I hate it for you, bro. I really hate it for you.
Even getting out of bed is hard because I have lymphedemas on both of my legs, which means my legs are permanently swollen.
Not permanently until you get that weight down. You will have a couple, you probably will have some surgeries, but your legs will be fine there, bro. Your legs will be fine. Another thing, too, this body positivity wave that's going on. I want to ask you something. Is this body positivity? Are you not going to tell this person the truth? Are you not going to tell this person that they're unhealthy? Because if you don't, you're really doing people, you're really doing them a disservice. If you just let them say, hey, look, for your height, you got a little too much weight on you. Unless it's muscle, then you're going to have to get rid of some of that. It's not being negative, it's being factual.
The second I'm up, I'm already in pain. And anytime I walk more than 10 feet, I can't even catch my breath. I'm exhausted all the time. And so I have to move carefully so I don't get stuck or trip and fall. Anybody that's my size, their biggest fear is slipping. If I fell, I'd have to call 911. But
you know, while I'm sitting here smoking this blunt, I was wondering something. Do the docs ever recommend CBD as an appetite suppressor, or smoke some indica as an appetite suppressor? Because that would actually help them a lot. That would definitely help them a lot to in the journey to lose weight. Get some CBD or some marijuana, THC, a strong either hybrid with a strong indica or just straight indica. That'd be a good appetite suppressor for these people. And the CBD comes to indica and sativa too as well. So, yeah, CBD with an indica dominant or in straight indica will actually help these people out. Just saying.
No matter what, I can't be up for long. I may be able to stand for 10 minutes at the most if I'm not leaning against something. And I just have to give up and get out. And I don't feel like my body's ever clean. And that depresses me because I am ashamed to have let my life get to the point where I can't even clean myself like I need every day. I try to shower every day. Sometimes I don't, sometimes twice a week. And it makes me feel disgusting. So I hate the whole process of taking a shower and getting dressed. I'm in so much pain afterwards. I can barely get dressed. I basically wear the same thing every day because I can only wear what's easiest to put on at this point. So I can't wear pants at all because of the swelling. It's out of control. So during the day, I have to wear special socks to keep the swelling down. But it's hard to wrap them on my own. So one part I have to get help from my mom to do.
What's going on? How are you this morning?
Love you.
Love you.
Will you help me put my socks on, please? I live with my mom, so she can help me. And it makes me feel really bad that she has to basically take care of me all the time.
I love Paul as much love as God can give you to give somebody. I'm always worried about him. He's just gotten so extremely large that it's out of hand. His legs are so tight.
I think I pretty much know what happened with this man. He went through some heartbreaking type shit, though, man. I'm guessing, I don't know, I never seen this video before, but I'm guessing that he had a woman that he really loved and cherished. Either she died, universe forbids, or she broke his heart, or she was a close friend we had a crush on. Nah, that wouldn't put him over the edge, but I think it has something to do with a relationship he had. and people kept screwing him over. I'm guessing, I don't know, I'm probably dead wrong, but either has something to do with some kind of abuse trauma or relationships. Or abuse in relationships. Never know.
So badly tight. Because his weight did a thing that made it where the blood doesn't flow. So Paul stays swollen and he needs those compression socks, but he can't bend over and put them on himself. So if I ain't doing it, then it ain't getting done. You see what I mean? Because he's too big to do it.
So, by the time I'm dressed, I'm in pain and exhausted, and I feel like a failure. Now, how I deal with that is I eat, and that's when my day starts to turn around. You know, after I get dressed, I make it to the couch in the living room. And that's where I stay for the rest of the day. And all I do is eat, because food makes me happy.
Food is also a comfort, a crutch, an addiction, and all of the above. Because, man, I'm telling you, I'm trying to, this man is a hurt soul, though, man. Something happened to this dude. I mean, that's what I'm feeling from him. Something happened to him that made him turn over the food as a comfort. Something happened. Maybe the fact that his father's not around. Maybe he was close with his father. He died. And then everybody, he thought everybody was going to leave him. Something, some kind of trauma happened to this dude. I can feel it. It's radiating from his body. It's radiating from his soul. I'm telling you. Something happened with this man. Either an abuse, either broken relationships, or or something was taken away from him. I'm just getting that feeling. I don't know.
Get some toast. Maybe some juice.
Yeah, I got it with juice.
I love you.
And
This just came to me while I seen his mother. Or she used food to show her love to her son. So every time he eats food, it's a comfort for him because that's reminding him of the love, from the love his mother gave him through food. Ooh, that could be it.
That takes everything back and makes it go away. I feel like there's an empty space there when it's not food. So food, it's everything to me.
Okay. I'm getting closer to some kind of trauma. It has to be some kind of trauma he went through.
And that all started a long time ago. From as far back as I can remember, I've always been big. My dad was 400 pounds, and my mom was overweight too. So we all were big, and I think that was partly because my mom was such a good cook. My mom's goal was to make us happy, so she was always feeding us, and that's how she showed us she loved us.
I knew it! She used food to show her love. I knew it! See? That's what happens when you're so spiritual, you can see into it. Oh my goodness, I knew it! I knew it. I just had to think on it. I knew it. She uses food to show her love. I freaking knew it.
And I just constantly wanted to eat, and I never wanted to stop. So, food was everything. But then, when I was 7, things at home started to change. My parents started to fight a lot more. They often wouldn't see each other for days because they were always working to make ends meet. So I think they would fight because of that. And so when I was around 10, they got a divorce and my dad left.
Bam! That's another one, I guess. I knew it. I knew there was some, either he died or they got divorced. I knew it. See, I'm telling you, It never fails with this show. There's always some kind of emotional trauma that happened. It's the reason why they turned to food. It's always the case. Nobody soberly with no issues ever turned to food like that. No one without issues never turned to food like that. Straight up.
So I just ate and ate to make me feel better. And by the time I was 11, I was already over 200 pounds. So that's when it started to get really hard at school. I was bullied, kids.
See, I can see into this man's soul. I knew it was something. He went through some kind of trauma. He was bullied because of his weight. He ate food because mom cooked, because that's how she shows her love to him. And his father left him when he was younger. I could see all this straight through him.
Because I was different than them. I was an outcast. And I was lonely a lot. So food was my friend. But I also started to hang around the people at the carnival where my dad worked when I see him, and they never made me feel rejected because they considered me like family. Since my dad was a third generation carnival worker, it was like the family business, and the carnival was my family. So I really didn't hang out with anybody my age. I preferred older people for a while, but that changed when I was 12 because when my mom worked, she would have a friend of the family watch us. And one day, we're going to the beach. And we trust this guy. And the guys, I thought I was a kid. And so we were going to the beach, and he started to rub on me.
I fucking knew it! I knew it! He had to go do some abuse. I knew it! I knew it had to be either physical, sexual, or mental. Come to find out, it was all three and above. Damn, I knew it! Hell, ooh, I am so good at this. Damn, I knew it. It always had to be some kind of abuse, some kind of trauma to make them turn to food. It never fails. I knew it. I'm excited because it's like, dude, I'm seeing right through him. I'm seeing the trauma, I'm seeing the hatred, I'm seeing the love, I'm seeing the confusion, I'm seeing everything going on with this person, and it's amazing me because I can't believe I'm that much in the freaking spiritual. I can see this shit. I'm not even a psychiatrist, never been to school for only took one psychiatry class. That's not enough for this shit I'm seeing, though. Man.
Then decided to whip out as private and start to. Really, I at the time to put it away, and then I wanted to go home, and basically told me, "You don't tell anybody else, you know. If so, then I'll deny you're a child." And because of that and what it did to me, because I felt like I could have stopped it if I said something, but just kept quiet and just used food to forget about what happened. And by the time I was 14, I weighed 475 pounds. Fitting in high school.
See that shit? Now I'm getting to the niggas. I'm not no longer excited. Now I'm pissed though. Because goddamn it, that motherfucker did not need to do that to that child though, man. I'm dead serious on this shit, yo. That motherfucker did not need to do that shit to that child. I'm telling you, he would not be in this position right now if it wasn't for someone else creating the fucking trauma that he's going through right now. That's some straight bullshit right there, my nigga. Straight bullshit. Man. Now I'm beginning to think Thanos and Satan were the good guys.
Became a problem. That's the age when everyone starts to date. I wanted a girlfriend, but girls didn't want the fat guy, so I just kept to myself.
See? Females rejected him because he was big. But let me tell you something. It's a cause and effect. If he didn't go through the thing that his mom, instead of showing her love, not with no emotion or anything like that, she put her emotions in her food and transferred the food to him. and did him a great disservice by sparking that desire. Then, a most trusted friend of your father, most trusted friend, was beating his off in front of you, trying to groom you into a sexual experience. Then the reason he did that is another reason why now your addiction doubled, because of these two motherfuckers in your life that made you no goddamn good. These two motherfuckers were like, did you a great disservice. A great disservice. God damn, I'm sorry, bro. I mean, I'm not here making fun of you, dude, but I'm just saying, I'm seeing here looking at you. I mean, I'm talking like he's here with me, but I'm just saying. I'm sitting here seeing everything that you're going through, and I'm only hearing you speak, but everything you're going through, I can see it. I can see the emotional trauma you're going through. I can see everything that you're going through right then and there. And this was only 2 fucking days ago that this video came. I'm telling you, I can see straight through you, my dude. And I'm telling you, dude, I hope you get every blessing in your life. I hope the people who fucked you over get everything they deserve. Karma's a bitch, and goddamn, I'll call it my woman any day.
And you need more, and food was all I cared about. I didn't even care about my grades. My grades got so poor, they held me back then. So by the time I finally did manage to graduate,
if he would have channeled his anger, his frustration into sports, that motherfucker would have been a straight monster, yo. This motherfucker would be like 17 years old, knocking over grown motherfuckers. He's the very first 17-year-old. Would have made the NFL. He would have just honed in that anger, that frustration, that hatred, that confusion, and focused that in on something like football or MMA. Boy, you would have been unstoppable, my dude. I would have paid to see your fights. Pay-per-view, live, I don't care.
I was very happy to leave school and all behind me, because I wasn't being bullied every day. But I knew I needed to work. So after high school, I went into the family business. I became the fourth generation in my family to do that. And I loved it because I felt like I fit right in. So I did that full time for the next 12 years. And I did my job well. It was a happy place for me. I got to meet new people, and they all had the food I loved. Fried chicken, big sausages,
of course.
Corn dogs,
of course.
Lots of bread and fried dough. I could have...
To be honest with you, that shit is sounding good right now, yo. Damn. It's too bad I'm on a water fest, but that shit sounded right, though. I don't even have that shit, but that shit sounded good as a motherfucker, though.
Have any of it anytime I wanted. And by the time I was 24 until I was 29, my weight rose to 600 pounds. So that's when my weight started to become more of a problem for me. I had to stop working because it was too hard to be on my feet for long. And that was a huge blow to my morale. So I just ate more to forget my misery. And so I got even bigger. It was a few years later, when I was 33, that I hit 700. And shortly after that, it's when I had to move in with my mom because I needed help. And I couldn't afford a place on my own since I couldn't work anymore. I live with my mother in a one-bedroom studio, and I hate that I have to make her sleep on the couch. So I feel horrible and like a failure. But the one bright spot in my life is my girlfriend, Jen. She came into my life a little over a year ago.
Okay.
A friend of mine that knew I was lonely told me about her and told me I should reach out to her.
I'm my man. Yeah, I knew you had a woman. I knew it. I knew you had a woman, though, man. Hey, I can't even get a text back. Well, God damn.
My buddy had told her about me, and she thought it was funny that I reached out to her to be a friend when I didn't know who she was. So from there, we started hanging out. And almost a year ago, I asked her to be my girlfriend, and she said yes. Same, it's happened to me. And having her in my life has given me hope that I still have a chance at life. But I know the biggest obstacle keeping me from getting to that life is my weight. My whole life revolves around food. So I...
Well, you know, bro, I mean, I've seen people like that, though, man. I've seen people who, whose waist is like, it's tearing them down because they think it's building them back up, but it's actually tearing them down. And like I said earlier, this whole body positivity movement, yes, most people should be feeling positive about their lives. But with that positivity, there's always an opposition to that. And you got to take the fact that some people think you're unhealthy. Some people think that you're not looking right. Some people is worried about you. That's why they saying it's like, dude, you're getting a little too big. You 5'4", weighing 300 pounds. That ain't cool. That ain't cool at all. That all that weight going to your heart, because it's like this big weight in this short little package, though, man. It's overflowing. It's not even fitting anymore, though. I'm just saying, though. I mean, if people say, hey, you're getting a little too big for your britches, and I don't mean that in a good way, then you may want to listen. I'm just saying.
Is a death coming up? Because my size is killing me. It's already taken everything else from me. And I don't see anyone most days except my mom and Jen. And she has to come to me now if I'm going to see her. And so our whole relationship mostly revolves on her coming here to eat with me. She lives an hour and a half away, so I know that's hard for her to keep doing. I want to have a future with Jen. She makes me happy. But I know that's not going to happen the direction I'm headed. So I feel like I need to change my life so we can be happy together.
Are you?
Okay, that's his woman. All right, my man. I'm not even asking that question. I'll hold all questions till when I see the after. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. But all right, you got a woman though, man. God damn. Like I said, I can't even get a text back in this bitch. I'm joking. But I'm just saying though, yo, that's good though, man. Got your woman by your side. That's cool though. I feel you. I feel that. I'm in my feels. I'm single. Just saying.
How are you?
Good to see ya. How you doing?
Oh, it smells so good.
God, look at I got hamburgers. And potatoes and appetizers.
Hey, Buck. So, she has a son, too. And it makes me so sad that I can't play sports with my girlfriend's son.
Thanks, bud.
I can't go for long walks with my girlfriend. And I want to change all that.
You will, buddy. You will. Hell, you could outrun all of us.
So I know I gotta change. So I'm trying to fight this addiction. But I can't do it alone. I'm feeling like I'm at a crossroads and I'm scared. Even though I'm finally starting to see that I can have the life that I wanted and I have hope, my fear is that it could already be too late for me, that my body's too far gone already.
Paul's hit rock bottom. My son is the size of three men. But he only has one heart. And I'm afraid. I'm afraid of losing my kid.
I only weigh 217. Oh, damn, she's right. Damn. The human body is something else. How the hell some of us can carry 1,000 pounds? Man, they're some strong people. You weigh 1,000 pounds and you're trying to walk weighing 1,000 pounds. Damn. Ooh, your legs should be strong. The human body is something else, yo. Man.
Me and Paul are very close, and I would say if my son doesn't survive, I will probably lose it. I don't know, but I know that I beg God all the time to let me go first.
I'm not ready to go. I have so much to change, I'm gonna die.
It's not your time yet, bro. It's not your time yet. I give myself 88 years. I mean, if I die before then, it is what it is. If I make it to 88 years, it is what it is. If I make it past 88 years, then that's not my fault. So, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Maybe I'm going to be on this bitch for like 200 years, though. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, that would suck. 200 years? That would suck, man. For real. What if I'm immortal? That would suck. Oh, man. That immortality is worse than death, yo. Because you have to constantly repeat all events over, over, over. Just different ways of doing the events. You got to be on this moment until the earth burns up. Damn. That would suck. Man. Oh, he's not that far from Texas. It's only a 3-hour plane ride, I think.
I'm going to talk to Dr. Now today on a video call to talk to him about doing this program. I know I need help and that I have to get some sort of aid. So let's wait before things get worse. But my big concern is that Dr. Now is all already in Houston. And if I did this program, I don't know how.
Texas is not that far from Florida, yo. It's only a three-hour plane ride, you know. Well, it is a damn near a 15-hour trip though, but it's well worth it, man. Cause shit, I'm about to make that trip down to Florida. Hopefully everything goes. Hopefully I stack my money and shit like that. It might be sooner than I thought. I'm manifesting it right now.
How that affected my life?
Hello. Hey, Paul. I'm Dr. Nazard, and how you doing?
Oh, there's my dude right there, Dr. Now, yo. Man, that's that dude right there, man. Man, I can recognize his voice anywhere. He sounds just like Droopy Dog, yo, for real. That's that dude, man. That's that dude, yo.
I'm good.
So, Carl, I understand you went to get some help to lose weight.
Yes.
Okay. So, Carl, what's going on with you?
A very large man. I'm 750 pounds, and I'm in dire need of help.
And you're in Florida?
Yes, I'm 11 Arbordale, Florida.
And Paul, I'm going to ask you some questions about your health and go over some specifics with you, okay?
Yes, sir.
You said you were about 750 pounds. So, how tall are you?
6'6".
So, you have a BMI of 87. Paula, how far you can walk?
I can walk to the end of the driveway.
Okay.
Maybe 500 feet.
And you get short of breath walking, or your stamina gives up?
A shortness of breath, and my knees start to give out.
So you can get on, but your mobility is severely limited.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, your weight is pretty high, but your BMI is under 100, so it would be safe for you to travel here. And if you're interested to lose weight and doing my program, you need to come down to Houston for a meeting and an exam. But even though it may be safe for you to drive to Houston, don't put too much time in you to go back and forth and keep making that trip multiple times. So, if you want to do the program, you need to commit to moving to Houston and stay for at least a year or more to do the program, okay?
Yes, sir.
So you think you can do that?
I would love to do the program, but I need to have some conversations first about moving.
Conversation with who?
My family and my girlfriend.
Well, it is not easy to transplant your life down to here and put things on hold. But in your situation, if you want to get help and lose weight, so there is something that you need to figure out. And you need to make a decision and plan on coming and see us in Houston if you want to do my program, okay?
Yes, sir.
Shit, fuck it. I'll be in Houston, shit, before you can blink your fucking eyes. I'll be in Houston before you can blink your fucking eyes, shit. Houston? No problem. Hey, fam, we're moving to Houston. Because that program, you know, the surgery itself, is damn near $10,000. Not to mention the hospital stay, not to mention the nutritionist, not to mention the anesthesiologist, not to mention the x-ray tank, not to mention the anesthesiologist, not to mention the medical assistant, not to mention the nurses, not to mention the surgeon assistants and shit like that. They're paying for all that, and you got, man, shit, take your ass down to Houston.
And then we go from there, okay?
Yes, sir.
But no matter what, this is all going to come down to whether or not you start making the changes you need to get healthy bone, okay? And that means that you're only going to eat 3 times a day, you know, snacking, and you're going to eat around 1,200 calories a day. That means that you eat about 400 calories per meal. So that is a high protein, low carb diet, and you start that diet right now, so you can start losing weight immediately. And once you get down here, we'll see where you are and give you a call to him to show me that you're able and willing to start making the changes you need. And if you do that, then we will move ahead with you. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So you have a lot of work to do.
You know what? You know what? He should have did like old boy did like back in 1950s, 1960s or something like that. This man went on a water fast for damn near over a year. This man went from 400 pounds to 135, and he was looking very healthy though. He was just skinny as hell, but he was looking very healthy. This man, his hair grew out and his skin was looking all nice, and he was just skinny though, you know what I'm saying? But his skin was looking tight though. See, he could have did that, but that's not for everybody. I mean, I could barely do 60 days, cause I only weigh 217, and before I start, and I'm on a 38 fast right now, and it's only been day 10, and I already went from 231 to 217. So just imagine, that's only in 10 days. Just imagine I'm looking for the rest of the 20. Or better yet, what if I decide to do 30 more days on top of that? Man, I would look like a damn crackhead. Nah, I'm good on that one. But he should have tried it, though. He would have succeeded on that one. He would have succeeded. Yeah.
To make the changes you need. And it won't be easy for you. You get that?
I do.
Okay, so tell me, what do your eating habits look like right now?
I eat all the time. I eat lots of sweets and a lot of food. I eat a lot of fast food, a lot of greasy food.
So what do you eat, because you're hungry, or you eat it from habit?
More of a habit than anything.
There is no excuse for that. So if you're telling me you're eating out to get up over 700 pounds out of habit, then it's time to change and break that habit. You got that?
Yes, sir.
Does anyone in your family enable you to eat like you do?
Not really.
Who do you live with?
I live with my mom for most of the time.
Does she feed you?
Yes, sir. My mom cooks almost every night. She cooks.
Is your mom, helping you to eat less, or she encourages you to eat?
She just puts too much on the plate, and I don't tell her no.
Well, if you don't know to say no, then you're going to be 700 pounds. So this is not a healthy way, and, you know, people like you, they don't make it to age 40. And this is very high-risk situation. With all that strain that you're putting on your system, any day your body can give out and you not going to make it. And that'll be it for you. So you have to realize that your situation is very dangerous, and you have to change your eating habit, and it's...
Dude, listen to everything this man's saying. If this man's saying you will lose weight by eating dog shit, you do it, man. I'm telling you, he knows what the hell he's talking about. His method's been proven thousands and thousands of times. Hey, dude, he convinced me that gastric bypass surgery could be a good thing, because me personally, at first, I was totally against it. I was totally against that gastric bypass bullshit. All you need is get your mind right, go exercise, push away the plate when you need to, and then you start losing weight like that. But, you know, my naivete, you know what I'm saying? Whatever. But, I mean, this method works too, obviously, shit. So, I mean, I seen it work for everybody. I seen people keep it up, and you know what I'm saying? They did what they had to do. So now he actually convinced me to actually accept the fact that there are people who need this surgery. I'm no longer against it. I mean, if it's a helpful tool for you to get healthy, then it is what it is. But I'm just saying, you could have did the same thing do natural means. But, you know, to each his own, you know what I'm saying?
This is going to be all up to you to make that decision, okay?
Yes, sir. I'm ready to do it, sir.
Is your girlfriend encouraging you to watch your diet, or what's going on with that?
She tries to watch my diet and cook better, but I sometimes just go eat stuff that I shouldn't eat.
Well, that needs to change immediately.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Right now, it's very important that you stick with the 1,200 calories a day diet and do your exercises.
Yes, sir.
But if you want to do this, it's going to be up to you to make the healthy choices with what you eat. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
And the most important thing about the diet is that you don't snack. You only eat it 3 times a day. And that diet is... no carb on your diet, and protein, and a lot of vegetable, like a salad or cooked vegetable on your diet, okay?
Yes, sir.
Well, if you need anything, give me a call.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye now.
Bye. I know I need to make my health a priority.
Say this one more time. When that man says what you need to do to lose weight, you listen to every God word that he says, like it's the word of God, if you believe in that sort of thing. You better take that man's word like it's a prophet. You better take that man's word. If that man says you need to eat pussy to lose weight, then God damn it, you find a female and you eat the shit out of her. You will listen to everything that man is saying. I know I would if I was in a position.
Like Dr. Ma says, it's just I'm scared about what Jimmer's going to think and what it's going to mean for our relationship. I just don't want to mess things up with her because she's already told me she wishes we live closer. So this is tough.
Yo, check this out, man. When you lose that weight, your relationship is going to be beautiful. You want to know why? Because the simple fact of the matter is now you get to swing around without having to, you know, lift your stomach up. I'm just saying. That's going to be a plus. Thank you later.
Because both options for me seems like a big risk. So I feel like I just need to discuss it all with Jennifer before I make a final decision. So I just hope that...
Listen here, bro. There is nothing to discuss. Like I said, you listen to everything that man tells you. And that man says you have to move out of Houston to get healthy, to get rid of those anemias, get rid of that bulge, get rid of that fat, get rid of that unhealthiness, get rid of that mental block, get rid of all that, because all that's available to you, psychiatrists, you know, saying dietitians, all these resources available to you, free of charge. You better take advantage of everything that man's giving you. there's some people, like this one girl, I ain't gonna mention her name, she didn't take advantage. That's why she's stuck in the same position that she is, because she did not take advantage. Because she was young and dumb. And she didn't want to listen. You know what I'm talking about.
This doesn't end up messing things up with us in the end. Today I'm headed to Houston to see Dr. Down in person to start his program and to see what I have to do to get weight loss surgery with him.
Mom, you ready?
I'm getting there, babe. Just got my meds.
I don't think my truck will make it all the way to Houston, and I can't fit in my mom's car, so I didn't have an option until my friend JJ offered to take me. So I'm thankful she is willing to be a good friend and do this to help me out.
Hey, JJ in the house.
I'm going to Houston. You ready for a road trip?
Yes, I'm ready.
I'm Jessica. Paul calls me JJ, though. It's a nickname I've had my whole life. Me and Paul have been best friends, you know, pretty much our whole lives.
Hi.
Are you excited? It's going to be a whole, you know, chance at a new life for him, you know, just be able to live a normal life again.
You guys ready?
I'm ready. You ready, Jay?
Been ready.
Yeah, they're definitely homies, though. There's definitely no sexual tension between those two. Because I have a feeling that he's not her type. I could be wrong, but, you know, I'm getting that feeling.
Ready to load up?
Get your luggage. Let's go.
All right, let's go. Overall, I'm nervous about the trip down there just because of how long it is. This is going to be a 1,000-mile trip. That's a total of 15 to 16 hours of just driving. But my big concern is that after a couple of hours, it's just going to get too hard for me. But my hope right now is to divide up the drive across 2 days so I don't make it too hard on my body. But how I'm going to handle being in a car for 7 to 8 hours at a time, I still don't even know. Right now, my plan is to take it an hour at a time.
Where do you want this in the front, back seat?
The third seat would probably be better.
If it starts to get too much for me and I get sore, I know we can stop and take breaks.
All right.
It's kind of heavy.
And I'm definitely going to want to eat when I can on the way there.
I'm amazed that you're walking, bro. Not a lot of people could walk with 750 pounds, dude. You was a beast, cuz. I'm just saying, dude. You was a beast, straight up.
Because this trip down there to Houston is kind of my last chance to eat.
Yeah, I think so.
Because I know when I get to Dr. Now, everything is going to change.
If you listen to him, of course everything's going to change. Man, you be able to fit in the car without having to take up 3 seats or take up 2 seats. And you can actually, you know, get on an airplane and just sit at one seat. You don't have to pay for two. And, you know what I'm saying? Your girl can get it on like Donkey Kong. You know what I'm saying? Shit, there's a lot of advantages. Listen to that dude right there. Listen to him. Listen to everything he says and do everything he says. If he says you have to jump off the Empire State Building, land on your feet, do 10 push-ups and 10 jumping jacks, and you run in place for 30 minutes, all the while you're bleeding. I'm joking. All the while you're doing 3 sets of 15 burpees, 38 count bodybuilders, man, you better do it. Shut up.
We've been on the road for about an hour and a half, and I'm starting to feel it.
Hey, guys.
Yeah?
I'm hungry. Right. Can we stop?
Yeah, sure. Where do you want to stop?
Some fast food.
I got a question, though, man. This question I've been having ever since I watched this show, yo. Why the hell are these people not telling them no? What these people going to do? Run after you? Come on, man. No, it should be your favorite word. No, I'm not giving you no damn fried chicken. No, I'm not bringing you a fry to your bed. No, I'm not giving you the whole pizza. No, I'm not going to Taco Bell, KFC, and A&W all in one rip and feed you that bullshit. No, no, no.
So I told JJ I just need to eat and call it a day. So we find a hotel up ahead and we're getting some fast food and then going to rest, which I'm very happy about because this has been so much harder than I realized it was gonna be. And it's taken everything out of me to even make it this far. So I'm disappointed in myself because we didn't even make it out of Florida. We needed to at least make it to Alabama to stay on track. But I did the best that I could and went for as long as I can handle. It just got to be too much for me.
I need a double quarter pounder. And then another double quarter pounder with no pickle, no...
Oh, hell no, bro. You should have had Burger King. At least they got the Impossible Burger. Hell no. You eating McDonald's, my dude? Hell no. No wonder. Shit. Leave that bullshit alone.
Onion. I need a McDouble. Add Big Mac sauce. That spicy chicken sandwich. A 10-piece nugget. A large fry. Need a large...
Okay, you know what? I'm high as hell, and I haven't eaten in 10 days, but that shit is looking kind of good right now. But it's McDonald's, though. That's one thing I would never forget. If it's Arby's, sure. If it's Wendy's, maybe. But McDonald's, boo.
It's chocolate shake. Can I get a baker's dozen chocolate chip on Wednesday?
I'll have some of your nuggets.
And an apple fritter. That'll be it.
Dude, you just ordered one everything on a menu. You talking about, you want it? Oh, damn.
I have to spend like 11 hours on the road tomorrow. And I don't know how I'm going to do that. But I'm just trying not to think about it right now. Because I'm in so much pain. I just want to eat.
Dude, that's like a crack addict. Knowing that crack is bad for you. Knowing how you look when you keep smoking that bullshit. You keep chasing that dragon, that first feel-good moment, which will never happen again. Just saying.
And go to sleep. At this point, I'm so sore and so much pain that I'm worried it seriously could take me a whole day to bounce back from this. But I'm just trying not to think about that or anything that stresses me out. Not further. I just need a bed and to be able to sleep for a while. And hopefully when I wake up, I'll feel a lot better. And I'll figure out some way how to make it easy tomorrow.
Oh, here we go.
So far, this trip is kicking my butt, and it's just a lot harder for me to be in the car that long than I thought I was going to be. I was worried about that, but I didn't know how bad it was going to be, because I can't even remember how long it's been since I did a trip like this. So when I hit that wall with my body, around the third hour in the car, it took me by surprise. And there was a part of me right then that started thinking that this was a mistake and that I bit off more than I could chew. And trying to make this trip and go this far. But I know that I'm doing this for an important reason. So I have to keep going.
Where's your girl? Hold on. Where's your girl at? Now I'm tripping like your homegirl's there, your mother's there. Where's your girl at? Where's your girl at, dog? Is she driving your truck down to Houston? Or where's your girl at, dude? Now I'm tripping like, wait a minute, where's your girl at?
Or how hard it is.
Here, yeah. You want to get your shoe off?
Yeah. Let me help you. Oh man, your legs are so.
I'm just gonna go to bed. It really hurts.
Come on, we'll help you.
You wanna try to get under the blankets?
Yeah. And even though I don't know how I'm gonna figure out how to push myself to get to Houston on time, a whole lot is dependent on me making it.
Here you go, babe.
You guys turn lights off, please?
Yeah.
And getting the chance, I need to lose weight. So whatever it takes, I'll figure.
Wait a minute, you still in Tallahassee? Man, that's only 2 hours away, I think. Maybe three, I'm not for sure.
It's gonna be hard. Somehow, I have to make it to Houston. I slept past breakfast, so my mom and Jay went and got me something.
Hey, son.
Thank God the food's here. I'm starving. So I'm gonna have a bite before I left.
That's good.
And hopefully give me a little boost to start out. As soon as I eat, we're gonna hit the road and do our best to get to Houston today. Before my appointment with Dr. Now tomorrow. That's good.
How'd you sleep last night?
Rough.
Are you still hurting? Being in the car all day? The trip, I think, has been a lot harder on Paul than we really expected it to be. You know, someone 700 pounds his size being crammed in the car, it's hard on his legs, and it's really rough, and we're all tired, but I know it's taking a toll on him worse, and he slept in this morning. You could just tell his body's tired and he's hurting, and now I'm really concerned we're gonna miss this appointment because he slept in longer than he should have, and I, you know, could not get him up and moving and out of bed. It seems like he's just dragging today, and I'm really concerned and stressed out. I don't mean to rush you on eating, but we really gotta get going. We're gonna probably be late for your appointment, Paul.
Yeah, we'll be good.
We overslept. Like,
we'll be good.
You don't have to eat all of that right now. You could save some. I feel I'm trying to pressure him and push him, and it's been hard to get him motivated and going, and I just want to get on the road and get to this appointment, and I feel like I'm the only one really taking it serious. Paul, like, you don't have to eat all of it. You don't have to eat everything there.
Dude, do me a favor. Throw the rest of that bullshit away. Get the hell up and leave. Damn, is it? Dude, get up, get your ass in the car, and get the hell out. That's all you gotta do. That's all you gotta do.
I remember.
I'm very concerned about Paul's eating. You know, we're on our way to see the doctor, and I know he really has to start the diet after, but I wish I would see him trying to put in the effort now ahead of time. I had the surgery, and it's really a mental thing, so you have to be mentally prepared to stop yourself from eating, and it's hard, and I just don't feel like he's really taking it as serious as I wish he was, and I know it's hard, I do, but he won't stop eating. And I try to tell him, are you sure you're still hungry? Like, and he says yes, but he just doesn't stop, and I'm really concerned.
You're a bit too
bro, shut the hell up, get in the fucking car, and leave!
I am it.
Doctor now isn't going to approve the surgery because he's not going to see what he needs to see from Paul. Like, he wants to see that you're dedicated and ready for this change.
I'm like, bro, if you fuck up this opportunity, that's your ass, dude. Straight up. Do not fuck up this opportunity. I'm just saying.
Changing. He's not going to want to waste his time on somebody that's not going to put in the effort. Can we go now?
Yeah.
And I really want this for him, but I'm really worried. like he's not gonna get approved for it. I'm so concerned about him, and I don't wanna lose my best friend.
The one thing I do have to look forward to is the food on the road. My plan is to use that to try and motivate me to push myself to keep going today. So every time I make it another 100 miles closer to Houston.
See, that soda bullshit. Stop drinking that bullshit. Drink some water. Water. Water is beautiful. Water is more potent than air, man. Water is more potent than food, man. I like water. See? That's good for you. Fuck that soda shit.
I'll reward myself with something good to eat. And if I do that around 6 or 7 times, I'll be able to make it to Houston. I don't know if that's going to be enough to help me deal with the pain. Especially after a few hours. But at least it gives me something to try and do to keep going. So hopefully that helps. But I'll just have to wait and see how it goes and how I handle it all. I'm just worried because of how sore I already am and how hard I know it's going to get for me. But all I have to do is keep moving forward and do my best. And hopefully I can make it. I'm really tired. I lasted as long as I can today. But I'm at my limit. So I told JJ we had to stop. She wants me to keep going because we still have 5 hours left to go to get to Houston. We're about to be in Louisiana. But I can't do it. I have to rest. I really want to keep going, but my body just can't take it. It hurts. My knees hurt. I don't know what this is gonna mean about tomorrow or my appointment with Dr. Now. But I can't think about it right now. I just need to get in the bed and rest. Oh. So I don't know what we're going to do about getting to my appointment on time, but I'll figure it out tomorrow. Because I don't have it in me to do anything more today.
Mom!
Coming.
I'm just done. Chance of making it to Dr. Downs in time for my appointment. My appointment is 5.5 hours from now. So that's tight, but we can make it if we don't stop a lot. We need to get on the road. JJ says it'll look bad in the show, Dr. Now. I'm not invested in doing this, but I am. I'm very invested and I want Dr. Now to know that, so I'm gonna push myself and try and make it today. I just hope my body can handle it. We made it to Houston and I'm so very thankful we're getting close. I mean, it's like we're gonna make it. Appointment's at 1:30 and it's a little past 1 now.
Yes, I forget. He's Louisiana. Yeah, Louisiana and Texas are not that far from each other, so yeah.
And We're about 30 minutes away, so we may be a little late, but pretty much on time. And I'm in a lot of pain because we mostly done a straight shot down at Interstate 10 to get here with just about no stopping. So I'm really looking forward to just getting there and being able to get out. My legs are so sore, but I'm just glad we made it. We're a little late, but not too bad. So I don't think Dr. Now is gonna be upset.
We're ready?
Yeah.
Ready to do this?
Yeah. But I'm really getting nervous about this appointment because we had to rush here so fast that I haven't had time to kind of mentally prepare myself to talk to Dr. Now and do this.
Well, you better mentally prepare yourself now because, man, it's going to change your life.
I just hope that he has a plan for me that can work, so I can finally lose the weight.
Mr. McNeil?
I know that I have a lot to lose, no matter what my weight is today. But I hope the number I get from the scale today is at least in the range I was at last time. It's been at least 5 months since I got my weight, and I was around 750 then. So if I'm around 800 or something like that now, it's gonna be a huge shock for me. I'm worried.
How? Dude, you ate damn near the whole meal McDonald's. You ate 2 big-ass burritos. Bruh, hey, your mom feed you eggs with cheese and onions and pork bellies and all this other shit. Dude, if you not damn near 800 pounds, you fortunate.
I'm nervous about that, and I'm in a lot of pain still, and I feel rushed, so I'm just hoping I can get through this and it all goes right, because I'm gonna fight to save my life, and if I don't get a plan to do that today, then I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm at Dr. Now's for my first in-person appointment with him, and I'm about to get my weight.
Go ahead and step on the scale.
Bruh, if you are not damn near 800 pounds now, I'm guessing between 760 or 780. Around there. If you over that, then you know what it is, bro.
I was 744 about 4 months ago. So I'm hoping I'm still in the 740 range.
Oh.
It's gonna be okay, Paul.
Oh, son. What are we gonna do? Gotta do something about it.
Never gonna.
7 pounds over. That's actually not bad. You know, you're 750. You really around that range. 750, 757. At least you're not 800. At least you're not 760. Small victories, bro. Small victories. I mean, you did gain 7 pounds, but not that. 7 pounds is what? A 5 minute, what, a 24 hour fast? Just saying.
You're gonna see that number again.
Never again.
Whenever you want to mess up, just remember seeing that number and how you feel right now.
Yeah. I gained a little, but not a whole lot. So I'm a little relieved. 750 pounds. It's still a little embarrassing to see it come up on the scale. And when it did, it made me sick to my stomach. So I'm here to change. I just hope that Dr. Now is able to give me an option and a plan to help me do that.
Well, he's definitely gonna give you an option and a plan and a nutritionist and a psychotherapist and everything else. You don't get it, bro. You don't get it. And then when you start losing weight, being healthy, your hair's going to grow like, woo. You know what I'm saying? Get all the ladies looking at you, just not your girlfriend. You know what I'm saying? But your girlfriend was there for you at your worst, so I advise you not to do anything to fuck that up.
Boo.
Hey,
young dude.
Hey, Donna.
All right, Paul, you finally made it. Just a little late, but you're here, so I'm glad to see you. So, how was your trip down here?
Long.
All right, how long did it take you to get down here?
Almost 3 days.
3 days. Are you home down okay?
My body hurts. Tired.
Tired and your body hurts? So that's a lot of strain on your body going back and forth. So this is not going to be something that you're going to be able to do. And that's why it's important you move here. So if you want to do the program, then you need to plan to do that. And stay for at least a year. It's possible for us to keep the track of your weight and make sure that you stay committed. And
as I'm going to say this again, if that dude tells you to move down to Houston for 1 year while you're getting everything they're offering to you for free, they'll even put you up and help and pay for your residency, then goddammit, you do it. No excuses. No. No. No words needed anymore. You do it. Damn it.
If we need to intervene to get you back on track, it won't be possible to do it being in Florida. So that is something you need to consider. But I'm glad you made it here this time.
Thank you.
So, Paul, you weren't kidding about your weight. You're over 750, and that's a lot. But thankfully, you're still mobile. But no one that way is getting food without some help. So, who you got with you?
My mother and my best friend.
All right, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So, who is enabling you more, your mother or your friend?
Probably me, because he's with me more.
So, you are the one that you encourage him to eat whatever he wants, whenever he wants?
Allow it.
Be truthful, goddammit. Truthful, it will only help you in the end. That shit fuck with you, that's pride. Pride never helps. It always hurt. Fuck pride. Tell the truth.
And I give it to him. And I cook. So I said it before and I'm very, very sorry because I was a big woman myself and I ate wrong. And then, you know, just tragedious things happened. And Paul would get bigger and bigger. And then when he'd say he wanted something to eat, I'd fix it for him.
So how did you lose your weight?
Actually, I had, it started out, I had a gallbladder problem. And so I took my gallbladder out. And then I just decided to take a change on my weight. And I tried to go on just like chicken, very little starches that, you know, lots of vegetables and no sweets.
Well, you're doing that for yourself, but you're not doing that for Paul.
Well, Paul, I,
Dude, what the hell? See, you should have did that for your son as well. Maybe he won't be in the position that he's in now. Push the plate away of that junk food. Give him some fruits, some vegetables, some good cuts of chicken, you know what I'm saying, some good cuts of turkey. Some seafood, no shrimp, but like fish, salmon, you know what I'm saying? Chock full of good carbohydrates. Or either go vegan, you know what I'm saying? Go raw vegan, go, you know, vegan that, you know, you'll eat anything from any animal, you know what I'm saying? No animal byproducts, no anything like that. You could eat like that. You could be raw vegan, you know what I'm saying? I never heard of anyone getting fat. Weighed 750 pounds over a vegan diet. Hell, not even the processed vegan foods. That can't even happen. You know what I'm saying? Just saying.
He was on the road a lot, so he wasn't always home.
Then when he was home, I tried to make him happy and fix what he wanted to eat.
Well, I didn't see it before. Looking at his leg, and you think he's happy now?
Yes, sir.
So this is the dynamic that we need to change, but I don't know how we're going to change that.
I know how we're going to change it. We're going to try. We're going to try, and I'm going to cook right. And he has a young lady that he sees, and she has already told him that the food will be cooked good, too. So we're not going to do things in front of him, and we're going to try to just all start eating healthier. Yeah.
So, Paul, you come down to Houston. Who's going to be with you?
I mean, I wanted my girlfriend to come, but I don't think she's able to make it, so I'm not sure yet.
You're going to need somebody to help you out, because you'd be alone. Because if anything happened to you, if you fall, who's going to help you? And somebody need to be around with you so it'll be safe, okay? So if you want to do the program, you're going to have to figure that out.
Yes, sir.
So just think about that and let me know what you decide. But for the time being,
to me, there's no decision to be made. It's already done. I will stay down in Houston. Say with me now, I will stay down in Houston. Do this program. Get healthy. Say it with me now. There's no thought. There's no reasoning. There's no, maybe I shouldn't do it. Maybe I should. No! Say yes. I'm going to move to Houston and do this program. That's all you gotta say.
Your mother is going to stop enabling you?
Yes.
Is that what your mom said?
That's what I said.
And your friend is not enabling you, huh?
I do sometimes. I'm a little more stern with him because I also had the surgery 5 years ago, so I know the struggles, but...
So everybody look like they know what to do, but not for the bond. Yeah. So let's keep Paul happy and give him more whatever he wants.
Instead of making him permanently happy, we try to make him happy in that moment. But we know it's not good, and we have to change.
So this is all more reason. You need to be here so we can get you to be accountable for your eating habit, okay?
Yes, sir.
But until then, you need to realize that enabling people are going to be around you, but ultimately it is your responsibility to change your eating habit.
Yes,
and that's going to be something that you're going to have to do. You understand that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, Paul. So right now, because you live so far, I'm going to set your next appointment for 3 months from now, because I don't want you traveling again too soon after this trip. But at that time, you need to lose 100 pounds in 3 months. You think you can do that?
Yes, sir.
So you should be around 650 by then, okay? And if you do that, I will approve you for weight loss surgery to help you lose weight. And then also, what's going on with your legs and all the swelling you got?
Lymphedema?
And you got ulcers down in your leg?
All the way down to my feet. Okay. Ulcers on the back of my legs, yeah. Doesn't really open right now, but sometimes they do open.
Okay, so what are you doing with the lymphedema?
I try to put socks on. I got some compression socks, but sometimes it's hard to do.
Okay, so how mobile are you and how much you can walk?
I can stand for probably about 10 minutes. I can walk to the end of my mom's driveway, you know?
You get short of breath?
Yes, sir.
So we have a lot of work to do with you to get you healthy, Paul. But
see, he's telling you this. There's no need for a discussion. It is what it is. Stay your ass down to Houston and get away everything they're giving you for free. It is what it is. There's no decision to be made.
But nothing we do is gonna matter if you don't make the choices to work. You get that?
Yes, sir.
Everyone come here to lose weight. The only way you're going to be able to do that is that you're going to have to do the hard work and you're going to make those changes happen. Okay? So you're going to have to prove that you can change your eating habit and motivate yourself. So that's going to be all up to you to do the hard work. Okay?
Okay.
So I sent you the diet and exercises a couple of weeks ago. Have you started following it and doing what it says?
Not yet.
So how does that make sense if you're telling me that you're ready to change?
I'm ready now, and I'm going to do what I need.
Okay. In order to get the temptation out of the house, and all the unhealthy food out of the house. Okay?
Yeah, get all those peaches out of there, those eggs, the butters, the milks. As a matter of fact, just get his ass fruits and vegetables, man. Mushrooms, tomatoes. Well, tomatoes are fruit, but romaine lettuce. Not corn on the cob. Brussels sprouts, celery. You know what I'm saying? Carrots. You know, some weird that one vegetable. Oh, avocados. Don't forget, avocados are fruit too. So. It's not a sweet one, just like tomatoes, but it's a fruit nevertheless. You know what I'm saying? Get you some sugarless cookies or something like that, man. Get you some of those low-fat ones, though. You know what I mean? Forget all that junk food shit.
Yes, sir.
Then Paul, follow the diet. You only eat it 3 times a day. Make sure it's a high-protein, low-carb diet. So I know I gave you some instruction, but I'm going to bring you it again. And maybe I'll give another copy to your mom so she can be more familiar with what you're going to be doing that, okay? Also, do your exercises. And if you do all that, you should easily be able to lose 100 pounds in 3 months.
Okay.
When you are 700 pounds, you can lose 100 pounds easily. So you get a lot of room to lose that really quickly. Okay?
Yes, sir.
All right, any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. I'm going to bring you another copy of the diet and exercises that I want you to do. I want you to go over it. I'll be back.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, sir. I'm glad to see that everyone seems ready to support Paul and do what it takes to help him get healthy, and that Paul feels he's ready to make the changes he needs to save his life. But as ready as they all are to do this, it's not going to be simple for Paul and his mom to change their dynamic, whether the situation or temptation.
I swear, he sounds just like Droopy, yo. His voice is entertaining but informative at the same time. And he got that deadpan look on his face. But he's a damn good doctor, though. Hey, if he has to shade your ass and get on his point in, then you just take that shit, goddammit.
The choice to do what he needs is to him. No more nothing to do and watching for the food. You get all this homework and start working on it. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And let me know if you need anything, and then we go from there. Okay?
Sounds good. Thank you.
Before you go, we do some tests, okay?
Thank you.
All right. And if you need anything, give me a call.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much.
All right. You're welcome. I'll see you all later.
See you later. Bye.
You follow every instruction on that piece of paper. Do what the hell he says.
So far, it is concerning that he has a few weeks to start making those changes. With the diet and exercises I sent him, what hasn't? So it's time for him to put action to all he's saying and show me he can do this, because if he doesn't, we won't be moving ahead with him.
I know I have to do this. I'm out of options, so I have to lose 100 pounds in 3 months and do everything Dr. Now says, starting now. I know 100 pounds is a whole lot to lose, but I'm actually excited about the goal, because I feel like I have a plan to fix things, and there's still time for me to turn it all around before it's too late. I'm making it to that goal, because I'm getting chance in life.
Dude, you will feel so much better, man. It's like a huge relief. All you gotta do is just keep it up, and man, you will never feel that pain ever again. If you wanna do high protein, get every vegetable and fruit there. Also, get you some salmon, get you some chicken, get you some whiting, get you some mahi-mahi. All that shit's high protein. I only just high protein and zero carbs. You'll do beautiful with that.
Right now, this is the only option I have to go anywhere where I have to walk a lot or be on my feet for a while. At least, this can probably count toward my exercise for the day.
You can have that without the butter.
There's too many carbs.
There's lava.
What to do than I thought. Just because I have to learn what options that I can get that work and what don't.
Bananas.
No, I can't have no.
I'm not supposed to have them because of my diabetic. I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah. There's a lot of good ingredients Dr. Nalan listed in his diet that I'm allowed to use to make my healthy meals. I didn't realize how many things have a lot of stuff that you're not supposed to have. But I know that's the stuff that makes it taste so good. So I'm not getting as much as I was thinking, but at least I feel like I got a good starting point to begin doing the diet. But I know this is mostly going to come down to having to make meals myself or with my mom's help. And that's not going to be easy to do 3 times a day. But I'm committed to doing this because I know everything depends on me losing weight and qualifying. So no matter what it takes, I'm gonna figure this out.
See that? See, you're doing everything right. You're doing a diet. You're doing hopefully you're doing exercises. And that's only 1 month. Month two, though, you know what I'm saying? Gotta kick it in gear, though. Hell, going to water diet, you know what I'm saying? That'll do you right too.
For the past month, I've continued making a lot of adjustments to what I'm doing.
So you're looking
after
good there.
Shopping.
Bro, I can already see the difference. You're looking good there, bro. You know what I'm saying? You doing it, bro.
For some better ingredients. My mom did what Dr. Now said and threw out all the bad stuff in my house so it wouldn't be there to tempt me. And it was hard to watch all that stuff go, but I knew it had to be done because I couldn't be around it. A part of what me and my mom decided to do was to have me start cooking most of my meals because her temptation is making the food taste as good as she can. That's how she showed people her love for so long. So she just instinctively puts butter in all this other stuff. So for right now, I'm trying to do my own cooking for most of my meals. And I learned to make some simple meals so I don't have to go back to the store as often. The first stuff I got from the grocery store ran out in less than a week. And I had to go back again. So I tried just to do simpler meals to stretch out what I have for longer so that doesn't happen again. And it's working some. I don't run out as fast, but it's only like an extra 3 or 4 days. So my mom's trying to help me by grabbing what I need when she can. But for the past month, I've been complying with Dr. Now's diet and only eating what I'm supposed to eat. And I'm making meals with only approved ingredients. So I feel good about that. But it's been a lonely experience because I'm having to eat alone a lot since I'm avoiding temptation. When my mom, Jen, heard for them to do it every meal. So I try to eat breakfast and lunch on my own right now. So I can make what I need and not be around anything else that can tempt me. I'm scared I'm gonna give in if I do. So I just make my meals and eat them. And then I try to occupy myself throughout the day. So I don't think about food and all the stuff I wish I can eat. And I'm making sure not to snack. Because Dr. Now made it clear, absolutely no snacking.
He'll chop it on a water fan.
And I'm also doing my exercises every day. Those were hard to start because walking is still tough for me. And the upper body exercises were a little tough to start at first. But I'm able to do all the stretches and arm exercises now. After doing them for a while, those aren't too bad, but I'm still trying to work on my ability to walk. Right now, I can't go very far. My limit when I started was the end of my mom's driveway. I knew I could walk that far because I've had to walk it to get to the car that was parked at the end of the driveway. I can't go much further than that. So I walked to the edge of the driveway and take a small break and enjoy the view for a moment. That makes me think about the whole world that's out there that's out of reach for me, that I can't enjoy or be a part of. And I use that to try to motivate myself to work hard. And then I head back inside to rest because that tires me out. And I do that twice a day, like Dr. Now said. But I'm noticing that when I come back in, that I'm not as out of breath as I was when I started all this a month ago. And that makes me feel good because it feels like it's some proof I'm making progress. I'm doing good. I have 2 more months before I go back to see Dr. Now and to find out how I did. But I'm determined to get to my goal to make sure I get approved for his program and weight loss surgery. And once that happens, the next step is for me to move there to Houston. And that's going to be hard and scary because I don't want to leave Jen. And I still don't know who's going to move.
Oh, well, you'll find another woman. Texas women love big dudes. Not like that, but you're going to find another woman in Texas. Get you one of them Houston gals. Get you right.
For me, but I know I'm going to figure it out because I'm ready to do whatever I have to and have a chance at the future I want with Jen. So until then, I'm going to push myself to work as hard as I can. And hopefully when I go back to see Dr. Now, it will be enough for me to qualify. For my second appointment to find out if I made it to my goal or not. And I'm a little nervous to find out. But overall, I'm doing okay. Just a little sore from the trip here. But it's not nearly as bad as last time. Because this time I flew. And that was an experience for me.
I can already see the difference. That's crazy. I can already see the difference. You lost that 100 pounds. I could tell.
Hopefully, this appointment is a good one. And I feel like there's a good chance it will be.
You're already walking better. Your hair looking, healthier, you know what I'm saying? Your hair's looking healthy. He almost got a neck. I can already see the difference. That's crazy.
Mr. McNeil?
The last time I was here, I weighed in at 757.
Yo, I think I know what happens. He lost over that 100 pounds. I'm telling you straight out. Either he lost 50 pounds. 50 pounds in 4 months, that's, I don't know. He lost 50 pounds or he lost over that 100 pounds. I'm telling you. I have a feeling he lost over that 100 pounds.
That was 3 months ago, and Dr. Now gave me a goal to lose 100 pounds by today. So that means my weight has to be down to 657 if I made it to my goal to qualify for Dr. Now's
program. Take those shoes off.
So that's what I'm really hoping to see on the scale right now.
Your weight is 695.
I got mixed feelings seeing that weight. Yes.
695. Let's see. From 750 to 695. That's actually not bad. Let's see. 750 to 695. That's. Dude, that's 90 pounds, though. That's crazy. That's 90 pounds. That's. Hold up. Let's see. 757 Still sick. I mean, still cool though.
Because I'm.
I mean, 62 pounds. I mean.
That's what I needed.
Hey.
But I did still lose.
It's only 37 more pounds, bro. Hey. It's little progress, but it's progress nevertheless. You're no longer in the 700 range. That's for damn sure.
But ultimately, I'm nervous right now because I don't know what Dr. Now's gonna say. I just hope it's positive.
Hello, how you doing, Paul?
I'm good, Dr. Now.
Where's your family?
Home.
So you left your enabler all at home?
Yeah.
Except yourself?
Except myself. I'm my own enabler.
All right. How was your trip?
It was a little cramped, but it was an easier trip.
It's a whole lot easier than being in the road 2 to 3 days.
Definitely, sir.
But still, it's a lot of training in your system going back and forth like that. So if you want to do the program, you need to move down to Houston.
I'm going to do that as soon as I get approved for weight loss surgery. So if you tell me today that I'm getting it, I'll move down here as soon as possible.
Well, you lost 62 pounds in the last 3 months, so that's positive. But still, it's a lot less than you should have lost.
I know.
So right now, instead of losing at least 33 pounds a month, you only lost 20. So that means that you're not doing the diet like you should. Because if you were, you would have easily lost what you should have. What did you do with your eating habit?
To only what's on it. So, I cut out bread and pastas and all the junk food. No sugars and sodas. I felt like I made a big change, but I guess it wasn't enough.
Are you still emotional eating at all?
I don't think I am.
So, you're working on things with Dr. Paradise?
Yes, I am, sir.
Okay, keep that up, but how's your portion size?
A lot smaller than what I usually eat. A whole lot.
Do you eat to get full?
Sometimes.
With the stomach your size, you shouldn't need to get full. You have a stomach about size of 3 footballs. So you need surgery to fix that so you can get full much quicker. So you need to cut back on your portion size.
I'll do that because I didn't realize that.
If you look at my book, I explain the portion size. So if you eat the meat, it should be around 4 to 6 ounces. So 4 to 6 ounces is what fits in my hand, okay? But then, when you're eating a salad or cooked vegetable, put that on a smaller plate so you'll have a control of your portion size. So, before you eat, you put everything on the plate so you see what the portion size are.
Listen to everything that man is saying to you.
So you can control that, okay?
Yes, sir.
So if you do that, then over time, you get full as your stomach shrinks.
I will do that, and I didn't realize that, but I'm dedicated to do this. I promise you, Dr. Now.
Okay, great. So here's what we can do. Since you show me some good progress, I'm going to reduce your goal to 50 pounds over 2 months. And if you do that, then I'm going to approve you for weight loss surgery. You think you can do that?
I'll definitely do that, sir.
Good. But remember, you have to move down here first before we go ahead and do surgery.
That's no problem, sir. If I'm getting weight loss surgery, I'll move down here and stay as long as I need to do your program.
Great. So lose another 50 pounds by cutting back on your portion sizes. And once you do that, move here, then we'll schedule your surgery.
You got it, Dr. Now. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, I'll see you in 2 months. Have a safe trip back, and if you need anything...
Listen to everything that man is saying. I'm telling you. I mean, dude, just listen to everything that man is saying. Can't say that enough.
Before the end, give me a call.
I will. Thank you, Dr. Now.
Okay, take care.
You too.
Bye now.
Bye.
I am very encouraged to see the progress I've made over the last 3 months. Even though it's not as much as he should have made, it shows me he's trying to make the changes he needs to do this. But it sounds like the portion sizes are the issue that he need to focus on still. And there may be some emotional component to that, to where he used to get full, to get the satisfied feeling he wants from food still, even though he has cut back. So if he works on that and loses another 50 pounds, then I feel confident he's ready to move ahead and get weight loss surgery as soon as he moves to Houston.
I feel like Dr. Now is fair with me, so I feel good. You know, I lost, but it was the goal I needed, so I didn't qualify this time. But even though I didn't get approved for weight loss surgery, I have an easier goal for next time. And I know I'm gonna be able to do it with what I've done so far and everything I've learned. So I'll go back, focus on cutting my portion sizes down, like Dr. Now said, and see if I can lose even more each month by doing that. Because I want to do everything I can to make sure my next appointment is the one I get my approval at. I'm done wasting time and wasting my life. So every choice I make from here on out, it's going to be one that moves me towards getting my life back. Because I'm getting back control of my life, no matter what it takes. Today,
I'm at the house
I used to work at to start working there again.
Oh, hey, Butch. Snap.
Portions, and I'm eating smaller sizes, and I'm able to get around even better now, to where I can even go out without the scooter now. I'm trying to figure out and plan my move to Houston and looking at places to live and all that.
We wanted that bunch.
I realize I need to save up some money to be able to afford to stay there for a year, because I'm going to be on my own. And I don't know what kind of job or work I'll be able to do in Houston. Carnival work is what I know.
You go out to customer service, work from home, you know what I'm saying? There's plenty of jobs in Houston. Plenty.
So I called the guys and asked them if I could jump back in. And they told me it was going to be no problem.
Hey! What's
up on this? They'd love to have me back. So I'm excited to be doing this and to see everyone. I just hope I can do the full day like I need. So far, I feel like I'm holding up pretty good. This is taking a lot out of me, but it feels good to be back. I really miss it more than I realized. So as exhausted as it's kind of like coming home, and I just miss being here. Sound weird, but this is where I grew up, and this is where I worked for my whole adult life. Right now, I'm gonna work off days, so it's not that crowded, just because I'm still nervous being around a lot of people. One thing that I didn't think about is being around all the food I love, the carnival food, because it's all the stuff I used to eat constantly, every day of my life for so many years. But I'm not gonna
You walking better though. That's I mean he's walking you walking he's walking better. I mean he's not all he's actually walking better. Huh. I mean he lost a lot more weight than 50 pounds, I can tell you that shit.
I'm gonna stay focused on the work. Once I lose the weight, then I can do the things I want with Jim. I'm hoping we can get married and maybe even have some kids together someday.
If we do that surgery, you can definitely have whatever you feel like, man.
And as long as I keep reminding myself of that, I know I can resist. That's what's helped me so far. Because right now, I feel like everything's coming together and I'm starting to get my life back. So I feel good about today, and I'm planning to keep doing this a few times a week. Hopefully I'll be able to save up a good amount before I get to Houston, because I'm determined to get to my goal and get weight loss surgery no matter what. It's been almost 2 months since my last appointment. with Doctor now. My next appointment with him is in a week, and I'm feeling pretty good about how I'm doing and my chances of meeting my goal. Ultimately, I'm still not sure what my weight loss is right now. But I stayed on the diet completely, and I made sure I'm paying attention to my portion sizes. And I've just really simplified what I eat and how I make my meals. The easiest thing for me is that I'm hard-boiling a bunch of eggs at the beginning of the week. And I put them in the fridge to use through the week. Or I get some sliced turkey with it. And then I make a simple salad so I don't have to cook for every meal. But having to cook each meal was taking a long time, especially doing it 3 times a day. And my frustration was that it increases my temptation to order something from somewhere because it's convenient and it's quick. But I've made sure not to do that at the carnival. I haven't given in once, even when I'm around all that food. So I feel like I'm getting more control over my eating habits, like Dr. Mal said. And that makes me feel good and confident. I'm doing good and heading in the direction I should.
I mean, bro, you lost over 50 pounds. I can tell you that shit for straight up, yo. Straight up.
When I started, I couldn't do a whole lot. Mostly, I can only do the arm exercises and the stretching, the upper body stuff. That's all something I could do. But it still made me really tired by the time I finished. But now, I'm barely breaking the sweat when I'm doing them, and I can do them a lot faster, because it hurts less with all the movement. So I've been happy about that. But what's been really great is my walking. When I first started 5 months ago, I could barely get to the end of my mom's driveway, and even that wiped me out. And now, I can walk for blocks. And that's been an amazing feeling. So far, my record is 9 blocks, and I'm working on 10.
That's a whole mile.
But I have to be careful not to accidentally get too far past my limit. Because whatever extra distance I push myself to go, I have to recover it coming back. So it's like double that when I do it. I don't want to end up hitting a wall before I go back home and get stuck out here. So I just have to be careful when I try to see if I can go further. So it's been a slower process figuring out what my limits are. But I'm really excited by how far I've come.
Man, you lost over 50 pounds. I can tell you that shit straight up, yo. Because, man, you walking hella far. You kind of far from your mom's crib. So, yeah, you definitely lost that weight, yo. You probably like 400 pounds or something like that there. You know what I'm saying?
With my walking and my stamina. Because that's been the biggest thing for me. Being able to go places changes everything for me. And it's opening up a whole new world for me. Being able to work again is a good example of that. So it's been amazing to just go outside. Enjoy being out and looking at the ocean. Just take a moment to...
See, that's right, man. Keep walking, homie. You know what I'm saying? You doing the damn thing, yo. I know people thinner than you can't even do have what you're doing now. That's crazy. Man. Dude, what's your excuse? Man, you... it's all that damn cigarette smoking. This man right here, he weighs damn near probably 400 pounds now. And he's walking hella far. What's your excuse? Is it massive?
Enjoy life. It's been so long since I've been able to do anything like that. So I feel great now. And I'm really excited about my progress. Because I know I'm working towards a better future now. And I'm doing everything I can to make sure nothing stops me from doing that. So I'm just hoping next week, when I go back and see Dr. Now, that my weight loss is enough to make it to my goal to get approved to where I need to be. Another appointment with Dr. Now. I flew again just just because it's easier than having to drive in. And I know the doctor now prefers me to put a less strain on my body. But I'm less sore this time, even from the last time I flew. So I think that's positive. It shows that I'm moving in the right direction. So I'm feeling really good about where I'm at and my chances of being where I need to be today. But like the other times, I'm still nervous because I just don't know what my weight's gonna be until I see it on the scale. But I've worked extremely hard to qualify for Dr. Now's program and to hopefully get weight loss surgery.
Mr. McNeil?
Because I know I'm not.
He lost more than that 50 pounds. I know for a fact, yo. He lost more than that 50 pounds, man. For real.
I'm not going to be able to move ahead unless I show him I'm ready to work at this. So that's what I'm hoping to do today. Because I know if I don't, I can't do his program. There's no other options for me out there. So I really hope I did it.
You know what? I know this for a fact. He lost more than that 50 pounds. I know it for a fact. Because look at him. He can walk faster now. He walk farther now. He taking smaller portions. Yeah, he lost more than that 50 pounds. Please believe that shit.
Back at Dr. Now's. See if I made it to my goal this time. And I'm really hoping I did. 2 months.
Of course you did, man. I can tell for a fact. I can look at your face. Your skin look clearer. Your hair look healthier. I mean, you a lot thinner than what you were, man. I know that for a fact.
So I made it down to 695. Doctor now gave me another weight loss goal to lose 50 pounds by that day. So if I made it, I'll be down to 645 today.
Dude, you lost more than that 50 pounds. I know that for a fact.
Your weight is 6.
Damn, look at that, baby.
Yes.
Look at that. Ha, I knew it. You lost more than that 50 pounds, yo. Man. Damn, baby. Good job, boy.
That's awesome. It felt really good to see that number come up. So I'm excited. I'm really excited. I set my mind to something.
Right.
I did it. And it wasn't easy. So it just feels really good to see it pay off, especially when I wanted it so bad. So I'm hoping that the next steps for me are to figure out how to move to Houston. Because Dr. Now is about to tell me that I'm approved for weight loss surgery.
Hey, Paul, how you doing?
Good, Dr. Now. How are you, sir?
I'm doing well. So you made it down here on your own again?
Yes, sir. This time it was easier, so I feel like what I'm doing is paying off. Yes, sir. I almost did a cartwheel.
All right. So, did you cut back on your portion size?
Yes, sir. I did like you said, and I followed the portions in your book. And it was just like you told me, because after a month of never feeling full with that amount, I started to feel more full with it. Not completely, but I was getting more satisfied with less.
That's great. That's good progress. Well, I'm proud of you for all your hard work. So I'm going to approve you for weight loss surgery. And I'll do that as soon as you move down here to Houston.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm so stoked. I'm so excited. I'm going to move down to Houston as soon as I can.
Don't take too long. But if you do, I expect you to stay on track and lose at least 15 pounds a month until we do your surgery. Which should be easier for you. And it'll be great if you get under 600 before your surgery, because it will reduce the strain in your system and will be easier with the anesthesia and all that. So, you think you can do that?
Yes, sir. I can do that. I can stay on track and lose the 15 pounds a month until we do the surgery. I'm going to stick to my goals and keep on pushing on the diet that you gave me.
Okay, great.
Good shit.
So I'm going to set you an appointment for 3 months from now. That will give you enough time to move down here, so you don't have to make the trips. And keep me posted about your time frame when you move in down here. But as long as you stay on track, we'll keep moving forward with your surgery, okay?
That's great, Doctor. I'm thankful that you prepped me for the surgery. It's a blessing. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. I'm proud of your progress. Keep working hard, and if you need anything before then, give me a call.
Thank you, and I will.
All right, take care.
Bye-bye.
I'm very proud of Paul. He has worked hard to do what he needs from the start, so I have no doubt about how dedicated he is to change his life and get healthy, and I'm confident he's ready to move ahead with weight loss surgery, and that he will be a good tool that will help him continue doing what he needs to get to his target weight. So as soon as he moves out here, we will take that step with him and then continue working to help him lose the 400 pounds he still needs to get to his target weight of 225 pounds. And I think with what I have seen from him so far, he should be able to do that within a year after his weight loss surgery, as long as he sticks with it and keep working as hard as he has so far. But I'm proud of him for how he has done, and I'm looking forward to seeing even more progress from him soon.
I'm excited, because this means I can keep on moving forward to work towards getting my life back. And I have a chance to have what I want, which is a future with Jen. So I'm happy that I'm going to be able to take this next step to get closer.
And I also notice he's not struggling to get in the car anymore. Okay, cool.
That a lot of hard work ahead, especially figuring out the move to come down here and all that. But I'm ready to do this. Whatever I have to do to have the life that I want, I'm ready for it. I flew back home yesterday after my appointment with Dr. Now, but I held off on telling anyone my progress and that I got approved. But right now, I wanted to do something special to tell Jen. This is beautiful.
Where are we going?
What you like to know. Ultimately, this is good news, as this is going to save my life. But the bad part is, I have to move away. And that means that Jen and me have to have a long-distance relationship for a while. We won't be able to see each other often during that time. And that's going to be really hard for me. But I'm doing this for us because I know if I don't, that I won't have a future with Jen.
Well, it's already past our anniversary. It's not my birthday. Not your birthday.
It's not. It's a surprise. I have plans to tell her that I did it and that this is actually happening. So I'm moving to Houston, but I'm gonna make her a promise. In 1 year, I'm gonna lose the weight and come and take her back to the beach. It's been a minute since we've been to the beach, huh?
It has.
She loves the beach. It's one of her favorite places. But I've never been able to go with her.
I can't wait to be able to walk on the beach.
Thanks, Joe.
It's impossible at my size to walk on sand. My weight makes a shift too much to walk on. So my commitment to her is that I'm going to go work hard to get healthy, to lose all the weight in a year.
Let's spin you around, all right? Ready?
Main reason I'm doing this is to have a better life with her and Riley someday. And I want that day to be soon.
So what's up?
So, you wonder why I brought you here, right? I know I have a problem. I have to take this leap and have the surgery by going to Houston. And I know that you can't go because there's work in Riley. I want you to know that when I'm done with the surgery, I'm going to push myself to lose all this weight. Right now, I'm not able to walk on this beach. I want to make this promise.
I know you can do this.
I love you.
I love you.
Marry that girl. Right there, dude. Marry her.
I understand why Paul has to go, but I'm not going to be able to go to Houston with him. I think the hardest thing is we're going to be apart 1,400 miles. I feel like our relationship is strong enough to...
Dude, All you gotta do is drive that miles, man. That's all you gotta do. You got vacation. I'm just saying.
Withstand this time away. I think it's vital for him to get healthy. Because if he doesn't, the strain that the weight does put on his body, I feel, will cut his life shorter. I think if Paul lost a lot of weight, he would be able to come out and do more things and be able to spend time.
You know, one thing about losing all that weight, it's just the one thing, it's that skin. Oh, man, I've seen that a lot. Like, that excess skin is just, that's the only bad part about losing all that weight, though. But it could be cut out or it could be bounced back, just lift some weights. But all that skin might have to be, you know, surgically removed. It's not skin. You know, they use that for burn victims. So, I mean, you know.
I'm doing those things with Riley and I want to be able to do things with him.
Hungry?
Yeah.
Paul made a promise to me that he was going to come back and take a walk along the beach with me. I feel like that's important because the beach is one of my favorite places and he can't walk with me right now. So I think it's a really nice promise and I would love to walk on the beach with Paul. It would make me very happy and I'm definitely going to hold him to it. I think that Paul will be very successful. I'm absolutely going to support him in his quest to lose weight. What sounds good to you?
It's something healthy.
Like,
Jen changed my life and gave me purpose again. So I owe her this. And even though it's gonna be hard for both of us to be apart, I know we'll manage this and figure it out to make it work. That's the chicken.
Chicken? Do you want black beans?
No beans.
No beans?
No sour cream. No cheese.
So no dairy on it?
Thankfully, I have a little more time before I'm leaving. And a large ice water, please. I want to get my surgery as soon as possible. The second that I have everything I need and everything lined up, I'm making the move. But until then, I'm making sure I don't slack on my diet. Dr. Now warned me about that, but I'm sticking to my diet. Because Dr. Now also told me if I don't stay on track, that I'll lose my approval. And I can't let that happen. But I know this means I have a whole lot of work ahead, not just to get ready for Houston and to move, but to lose the weight and to get to where I need. But I'm going to work my hardest to make sure that all that happens as soon as possible.
I'd offer you a bite, but you can't have the tortilla.
I don't need a bite, baby. I got the salad. It's good.
Every choice I make from here on out has one purpose: to get that life I want with Jen. So I'm using that to keep me motivated to my goal in that life so I can get back here and keep that promise I made to the love of my life and start the life with her that I'm dreaming of. And I can't wait for that.
Wow, you seem really serious about this.
I gotta be. Gotta make a better life for both of us.
I'm miserable. And food is the only.
So, that was my reaction video to the My 60 Pound Life. You know, I'm proud of my man's right here, though, man. He's going to do it, yo. I have a feeling he's going to do it, man. But, you know, it is what the only time will tell. I mean, too bad he didn't have the after effect here, but, you know, he's still working. This is only December 8th, so, you know what I'm saying? He still got a couple more months to go before he gets the surgery. So, I'm pretty sure they're going to keep up with him. All right, people, that's my first reaction video. Tune in that I'm going to do my podcast tomorrow as well. And I got to do not only my podcast, I got to do an unboxing of a product I got from one of my sponsors for my blog that I write about, that traveling vegan cannabis writer. And it's just one thing, though. It's not, you know, a whole box. It's just one little product, though, by one of my sponsors. So, that about wraps it up here, and I will see y'all later.